So again, that was Christopher Columbus and Mercy, Mercy, Mercy. That was episode one, the Phantom Jazz Band. Now we're gonna move on to episode two, Attack of the Brass. This is our brass quintet. These are the next three episodes will be chamber music things, or next four episodes will be chamber music ensembles, both a brass quintet, a flute solo, and a jazz combo, and a sax ensemble. These are all student-led groups that have been working hard to do this. So, up first will be Attack of the Brass, episode two. So, for episode two, Attack of the Brass, you're going to hear Sweet Adeline and the Entertainer. Thank you.
Nice shirt.
Next for episode 3 will be Revenge of the Flute, which will be Pan by Johansen Donjon, performed by Monty Manning. Alright, up next for episode 4, a new combo with hope. As the combo comes to set up, there we go. See, there is hope for them. Only a small amount of hope. I do want to remind you again, as it's almost 6:30 already, the art show is up until 7, so if you haven't had a chance to go up and see all the student artwork that is up in the library, you can go up and do that. There are snacks up there as well. There are also still some food over on the tables, as well as two forms on the table for those of you that are interested in helping out with some more things. There are kind of a multitude of events coming up, and of course next year being kind of another big year here for us in this program, there are lots of needs. One of those needs is to serve as kind of a leadership parent and supporter in the Johansen Performing Arts Association board. So there are 4 official board positions for that: president, vice president, treasurer, and secretary. And all of those positions are elected positions by the supporting parents and other community members that wish to be part of the organization. That election is happening next Friday night at our concert that starts at 7 inside of the theater. But tonight we wanted to start taking kind of nominations, self-nominations preferably, or if you think your spouse has some spare time, you can nominate your spouse. I won't tell. They may get a phone call saying, hey, thanks for being on the board. But hey, no, I won't tell them. I won't tell them who nominated them. How about that? But there is a nomination form over there, at least an interest form, so you can come talk to me or talk to one of the other board members that are here. Our current president is Miss Shirley Grinnig. And I know I saw her. Did she take Jack home? Oh, she's over at the table?
Yeah.
So Ms. Shirley Grinnig, who's our current president over the table at the green shirt, our current treasurer, Mrs. Marilyn Scheid, who's right here. And then our vice president, Legina Garza, who's, I believe, also back by the tables.
She's sitting at the table.
She's in the black, so everybody can wave to Legina. So we do have those board positions available. The other form over there is for our fireworks booth that is open from June 27th through July 4th. And it is really a very big summertime fundraiser for us, as that has brought in as much as about $10,000 for us before, but tends to bring somewhere between $6,000 and $10,000 of profit, which is a big chunk of change to get in the middle of summer to really start us off with the year really well. So if you want to volunteer or are interested in volunteering for that fireworks booth at some point throughout that week, there is a form over there that just has morning, afternoon, or evening. So if you know you kind of like work in the evenings, or if you want to help out in the mornings, or maybe you can help tow, there's a little slot for that too. But just kind of a general interest. That way when we go to call you, we kind of know what your availability might be a little bit, and that way you're good to go. All right, so episode 4, a new combo with hope, will be performing a song for my father. Sorry, song for my father. It is not a song for my father. Song for my father. Hello, Dolly, and Sir John. Please enjoy a new combo with hope. Thank you.
Thank you.
So once again, that was episode 4, a new combo with Hope. Up next is, of course, episode 5, The Saxes Strike Back. There are still some snacks, so if you're still hungry or thirsty, there are still some things to eat and drink. There is also, if you want to see Marilyn Scheid, our current treasurer, she has fireworks script. So if you know you always spend, say, I don't know, $1,000 on fireworks, you can prepay for those fireworks in script. So when you go to the booth, all you have to do is turn that in. You've already spent your money. So you can talk to Marilyn, you can set up a credit card transaction if we need to do that. You can write a check, you can take care of that. You can buy it in any $10 increments. The students will be selling them as well here soon, but Marilyn has some on her. So if you're interested in fireworks script or know people that like to buy, if you want to do like a block party, you can collect money, buy the script, you can show them the proof, and there's a little tag on there. You turn that in and you're entered into a drawing for even more free fireworks. So as long as you're 18 or older, but of course, if you're not 18, you want to buy the script and give it to your parents or give it to a family member, they can still go get the fireworks. You just can't touch it. Yeah. So again, up next, episode 5, The Saxes Strike Back. And they will be playing tonight for you, March Slav.
Yeah.
All right, well, so far we've had episode 1, the Phantom Jazz Band. Episode 2, Attack of the Brass. Episode 3, Revenge of the Flute. Episode 4, A New Combo with Hope. Episode 5, The Saxes Strike Back. And we'll wrap up the evening here with episode 6, Return of the Jazz Band.
Upstairs and see the artwork. It's good.
So, here is, of course, the return of the jazz band. They'll be playing for you tonight, American Patrol, St. Louis Blues, My Favorite Things, and ending with Fables of Fabus.
Thank you.
Before we play our last tune, I do want to talk to you again about a couple things upcoming and a couple things you can help sign up for. On the table are still interest forms, not commitment forms. You don't have to be part of the board if you sign that form, but you may be on the ballot next week. But we have our Johansen Performing Arts Association board sign up interest sign up over on the table where the helmet is. You can still put your name in for that. As well, we have our fireworks booth help sign up. So if you think you might be willing to help during June 27th to July 4th, any one of those days or all of those days, there's an interest thing in there. So that way when we start making our phone calls, we kind of know what to ask you about, which kind of part of the day is good for you, or whether or not you can help too. We also, of course, have a couple more events coming up at the end of this year. Next Friday night, on May 19th, is our concert band and orchestra end of the year concert. That is inside of the theater, so no wind issues. We also, that evening, will be having our Performing Arts Association elections. The day after that, on the 20th, we have our annual community outreach concert at the park over at Creekwood Park, aptly on Creekwood. But that is from 12 to 2 or 11 to 2?
11 to 1.
11 to 1, thank you. I don't know why I got confused there for a second. But this is a great time. We work with our Neighborhood Watch organization for Creekwood. They help bring out the Modesto PD to kind of come bring out the crime dog and just kind of be out and have fun. They usually bring out the fire department as well. They have food trucks. They have other kind of community service organizations out at the park just to kind of allow us to come out and have fun. There will be a bounce house for kids. So there will be food trucks. And of course, the jazz band, concert band will be playing all sorts of fun stuff. But it's a real fun kind of afternoon out at the park at Creekwood. So next Saturday on the 20th, you want to come out, bring out the whole neighborhood. So if you have neighbors in that area or have family and friends in that area, encourage them to come hang out at the park for lunch next Saturday. On the Monday after that, on the 22nd at 7 p.m. in the Vikings Den, is our annual instrumental awards night. And it is another dessert potluck, so it's a pretty fun casual night for most of us. But the students get their time to be honored and thanked individually and in front of people, so we don't have to take up concerts, because we all know I can talk, so I can take up the time in concerts, but I think we'd all rather hear them play. And then of course, after that, we still have graduation, which the jazz band will actually be playing at beforehand for graduation this year, and then there's, you know, the fireworks booth and the 4th of July parade that we'll be marching in once again. So make sure you're at our upcoming events. It'll be a lot of fun. Before we play this last tune, Fables of Phobos, I do want to take time. This is the first time this has happened. So we have two members of this ensemble that are graduating this year that aren't in any of our other performing ensembles for next Friday night. So I wanted to make sure I took time to individually thank them and give them their own individual round of applause. This is for Jose Ramirez. These are both four-year ensemble members that have been part of the program active. Jose's also been part of the Instrumental Music Council. These are definitely two students that have been very, very vital to the growth of this program over the last 4 years. The other senior that is graduating and not in the performing ensembles next week is Paul. Mississippi, to me, home! Tune, Fables of Phobos. guess for episode 7, you'll have to come back next week. Then we'll have episode 7 and episode 8. We'll be fully caught up. We're a little bit ahead of the game, I guess. So, thank you again for coming out. Have a great rest of your evening. Time for them to clean up. Thank you very much.